Hey guys, I've made another quick tutorial guide for you. This is going to be on my website, of course. You go to tutorials, click on Origins, and this one is going to be about how to get 8 perk slots. They are permanent. If you get downed and you're revived, then yeah, you still have them. This Easter egg will work on DLC 5, and again, it's going to open up your perk slot so you can carry 8 perks instead of being maxed out at 4. This doesn't require any gobblegums, and this is going to be like having a perkaholic, but by doing it with an Easter egg inside the game. And this Easter egg is kind of daunting, and most people probably don't do it because it's kind of a pain, but I'm going to show you guys the easiest way to do it and just like break it down for you. The first step is really easy. You just need to grab a shovel. There are 2 locations at spawn. There's another location inside of the wind tunnel next to the workbench, and then if you go to the church on the first floor by that number 3 torch, there's a location. The next thing you need to do is turn the shovel into a golden shovel, and you have to dig around 30 dig spots, and I take one path around the map to check all the dig spots. I start at generator 3 and go this direction through spawn. There are 29 locations to check, and if you faithfully dig and look for these spots every round, then they're going to respawn every round, and it's going to be anywhere from 3 to 5. I was on solo here, and I was able to get the golden shovel by round 10 every time, just like making sure I dug every dig site every time they spawned in. You also have to make sure you have the entire map open, so that does take some time, but if you make your way over here towards the excavation, go up through the church, you'll find locations here. Now, I'm just shooting at where they're gonna be. Some of the dig areas are there, but others, yeah, they're not spawned in. Again, I'm just showing you the route that I take so that I know that I'm checking every single location. So once I get to generator 6, I turn back and I go towards the jug area. The jug area has the remaining 5. There's gonna be 1 in the tank track, 1 here in the footprint, another in the other footprint, 1 by the generator. And the last location is dead center on this mound in this footprint right here. Once you get about 30 dug, then you're going to hear a ding noise, and you're going to notice that your shovel on the bottom right of your HUD is now gold. The next thing you need to do is get a zombie's blood, and you can get those from killing zombies. They'll drop those, the dig sites you just dug up, panzers, and also if you're playing co-op, it's going to be in spawn in the reward box. Another way to get one to spawn every round is to use the eye staff and shoot these flaming wagons around excavation. You need to do it in a certain amount of time. If you don't do it within a certain amount of time, it's going to reset. Again, you can produce a zombie blood by shooting these 3 flaming wagons every round unless it's raining. So if you have snow or no weather at all, you're going to see the fire coming out of the wagons. You can shoot all 3 of them and come up here and pick up a zombie's blood. Once you get into zombie's blood, you need to run around and find these hidden mounds that will spawn in. Now, these mounds do not show up where you normally find these normal dig spots. These are in their own locations. They're gonna be bright red, and you're just gonna hold X or square on them to dig them, and a golden perk bottle is gonna come out of it, and just walk over it and you'll collect it. This does not give you a perk. It just gives you a perk spot. It's opening up that ability for you to have more than 4 perks. And if you find 4 mounds, you can have 4 extra perks and carry a total of 8. You can see here I'm carrying 8 perks because I have found the 4 extra mounds, and this blopper I believe is going to be Widow's Wine for DLC 5. Again, if you get downed and lose all your perks, then you're not going to lose the ability to carry 8. You're always going to keep this 8 slot ability. There is a way to get the 9th perk, which is going to be the double tap out of the reward box, and you spend 30,000 points and it will give you a double tap. You just make sure you buy all 8 perks and then go get the double tap out of the reward box. The next step is the most difficult for this Easter egg, and that is locating these hidden mounds while you're still in zombie's blood. Here's a map here of all the locations. There are 16 locations where these will randomly show up. The reason there are 16 is because there's 4 players and each player has 4 locations. I do have this map on my website, glitchingqueen.com, under tutorials and then origins. If you look at the top left, it starts with number 1 and then goes 2, 3, 4 clockwise around the map, and I've done that for a reason because it's going to make it easier to run certain routes to be able to check out these locations, and I'll go over those routes later on in the video. So the toughest part, again, is to locate these mounds during zombie's blood, and there's 16 locations, so what do you do? Well, there is a shortcut, and I think this will work for DLC 5. You need to have like Simtex grenades or like Widow's Wine grenades. If you know where the 16 locations are, you can throw a grenade that will stick to it, and it will make it illuminate and show up. Now, you can't go up and dig this. You have to be in zombie's blood, but it will let you know where to run to whenever you do get zombies' blood. I've seen this glitch work in Black Ops 3, so I'm hoping that this will work on the remastered Origins. Now I want to show you guys the 16 locations for these to spawn. One is going to be by Generator 2, down by that trench where you pick up one of the shield pieces. Another is the tank track, the Generator 2 area right outside the door. Then this cutout by this wall by outside of spawn. Then if you turn around and go towards spawn, there's going to be one right in the middle. Then the fire tunnel has one down at the bottom. Then if you go back out, there's going to be a wall by right outside of spawn. There's going to be a location right in front of it. Now over there by Generator 3, there's a location right in front of that zombie spawn window. Then out on the track, there is a location that's going to be by the purple piece, you know, where you jump off of the tank, and then over there by Generator 3, there's a location right next to where the fire piece drops from that plane that you shoot down. Then over there by Generator 4 next to Jug, it's next to that workbench. There's another location from church going towards Jug. It's right before the drop-off in the middle of the track. Then if you head over to the church by Generator 6, there's going to be a location by this wall by near this generator. Then on the tank track going towards Generator 5 from the church, there's one right before it slants down. The right footprint of the middle robot below excavation, there's one in a puddle. And then another by Generator 5, the right footprint next to the soul box. Then from Generator 5 towards the Generator 2 area on the tank track, there are four puddles. And this is going to be after the fourth puddle. There's only going to be one hidden mound that's going to come up at a time. So when you get into zombie's blood and find it, you can only find that one. You have to wait until the next zombie's blood to find the next mound. Now I want to show you guys some routes that some of the community likes to run. These are pretty popular. It helps you to locate all of these with only three zombie's blood. So you can look at all 16 locations with three zombie's bloods. Here's the first route right here. If you hang out in this trench with the ice staff, you can most likely pick up a zombie's blood and start the route right there. You look at that location, then you can just crouch down, check out the one on the tank track, quickly peek over there at that one, and then the one towards spawn. And then when you go towards spawn and then out, you can just have a look down the fire tunnel. And then the last location is going to be by that wall by on the right. So with this route, you can see six locations. The next route is going to be by Generator 3 tank track. You want to start here, have a look at that spot. It's going to be real easy to see the one at Generator 3. Then run up here, make a right into that footprint, see if there's one there. And then you can go over by Jug and see that location, and then very easily see this one right here that's up on the tank track. The last five locations are going to be behind the church. If you start in the footprint right here, you can get a zombie's blood, and then you can see that location real easy by Generator 6. Then drop down and run this direction. It's a good idea to have stamina up. It's going to be really difficult to do this without it and see all the rest of the five locations. This one you have to absolutely hustle to see that last location down there on the end. So there's a location in the water in that footprint. Again, one by that soul box. And then here you really gotta like book it and try to like jump up even to see the one down there. But I really hope this helped you guys out. I had a lot of fun making this tutorial. I appreciate you guys watching, and we'll see you next video.